Hello everyone, my name is Hemant Pandey. I am a senior lecturer from Praveen Patil College of Diploma, Engineering and Technology. So the today's topic is semiconductor. Let's start. So the electronics materials, that means the materials which are used in an electronic field, are broadly classified into two types. One is conductor and second one is non-conductor. So let us know what is a conductor. So the material which allow the flow of current through it is known as conductor. Right, like for example, all the metals are conductor, iron, aluminium, copper, all these are a conductor because current can pass through it. Opposite of that is a non-conductor, that is the material which does not allow the flow of current through it is known as non-conductor, also known as insulator. Right, for example, rubber, plastic, glass, fiber, wood, all these are insulator, that is non-conductor. For example, the coating of the wire is made up of an insulator, right? Hence, when we touch the wire, we doesn't get the shock. So, it is a non-conductor. Now, between these two, that is conductor and non-conductor, there is one more material which is known as semiconductor. As the name suggests, semi, that is half of the conductor, right? So, the material which exhibit the property of both, that is conductor and non-conductor, is known as semiconductor. So let us go. What are the types of semiconductor? The semiconductor is broadly classified into two types. One is intrinsic semiconductor and one is extrinsic semiconductor. So as the name suggests, intrinsic, internal, right? So intrinsic semiconductor are those semiconductor which are in the purest form. That is, they are in a natural form. For example, silicon and germanium, right? These are natural. We don't made it. It is natural. Then what is the extrinsic semiconductor? The semiconductor which are formed by adding impurities to the intrinsic semiconductor, right? For example, if we have a pure semiconductor and we adding some impurity to it, then it will become extrinsic semiconductor. The extrinsic semiconductor are again classified into types, p-type and n-type. Now the process of adding the impurities to the pure semiconductor is known as doping. Now all the electronic fields, that is further we will go, we will see what is a transistor and all these are made up of a p-type and n-type. So we can see that all the electronics material are made up of p-type and n-type semiconductor. So let us go what is a p-type semiconductor, right? So as I said earlier, when an impurity is added to a pure semiconductor, what are the pure semiconductor? We have see earlier, that is silicon and germanium. These are the pure semiconductor. Now when some impurity like aluminium or gallium is added to the pure semiconductor like silicon, then the semiconductor which is formed is known as p-type semiconductor. Now what do you mean by trivalent? I have highlighted that word, trivalent impurity. Valent means valence. The valence electron of that atom having a 3 electrons in the outermost shell. Hence it is known as trivalent. Tri means 3, valence means valence electron. So if the atom has the 3 electrons in the outermost shell, then it will known as a trivalent atom. So if such atom is added to the silicon, then the new semiconductor which is formed is known as a p-type semiconductor. Let us know why it is known as a p-type semiconductor. You can see the diagram. Silicon and germanium both having a 4 valence electron. Silicon and germanium both have the 4 valence electron in the outer shell, right? Now when the aluminium is added, which have a 3 valence electron, what happens? It made a covalent bond with all the 4 valence electron of silicon. You can see in the diagram, one is created, second one is created, third one is created. But the fourth one is cannot create because aluminium has only 3. And hence it can create only 3 valence, 3 covalent bond. The fourth one becomes incomplete. And hence one space is created and that space is known as hole. So basically hole is nothing but an empty space, right? So we consider that hole as a positive charge. Why positive charge? Because hole represents the absence of an electron and the charge of the electron is a negative. Hence we can say that hole is a positively charged carrier. So in short, what we can say that when aluminium, that is trivalent impurity, is added to a silicon, then p-type semiconductor is formed, right? Let us see what is n-type semiconductor. So in p-type semiconductor we have a trivalent impurity, that is electrons heavy, that is three electrons in the outermost shell. But what happens in n-type, the impurity which have the five electrons on in the outermost shell is added to the pure semiconductor like silicon or germanium. So five electrons means pentagon have a five sides, so pentavalent, penta means five, hence it is known as a pentavalent impurity. So pentavalent impurity is, for example, is arsenic, phosphorus, right? If such atom is added to the silicon or germanium, then the semiconductor which is formed is known as n-type semiconductor, right? So let us go, just once again we see the diagram. We can see that silicon has a 4 valence electron, right? And a phosphorus atom is added. Now what happens? Phosphorus has 5 electrons, silicon has 4 electrons. So the the 4 electrons of phosphorus will make the covalent bond from the silicon atom. But one electron will remain incomplete because phosphorus has 5 electrons. So 4 covalent bond will become and 5 will become incomplete. So that electron will be a free because all the other electrons are bonded, right, by covalent bond. But fifth one is become a free electrons. Since the charge on that electron is negative, we can say that it is an n-type semiconductor. So what happened in p-type semiconductor? P-type semiconductor hole is created. And what happens in n-type semiconductor? N-type semiconductor we can see that free electrons are created, right? So this is the n-type semiconductor. Now let us see the difference between p-type and n-type semiconductor. So n-type semiconductor, pentavalent impurities are added, that is atom with 5 electrons in the outermost shell. In p-type we have a trivalent impurities which are added. In n-type majority carriers are electrons, right? We have seen that one electron is created, right? We have added one atom of phosphorus, hence one electron is created. The number of phosphorus atom we will add to the silicon, that corresponding number of free electrons will created. Hence we can say that the majority carriers are electron in n-type. Similarly in p-type majority carrier are holes, right? In n-type if majority is electrons, minority will be hole, and in p-type it will vice versa, that is majority is holes, hence minority will be electrons. So these are the basics of p-type semiconductor and n-type semiconductor. Thank you.